I have done a number of visits to psychiatric facilities in hospitals, and they're not sufficient. We've had suicides, we've had attacks on other patients, security is not what it should be.
The Democratic Alliance expressed concern at a leak report that as many as 80 psychiatric patients may have died in Gauteng last year. That's after the Gauteng Health Department cancelled its contract with Life Healthcare Sedimeni.
143 mentally ill patients in Gauteng died after they were transferred from Life Sedimeni facilities to unlicensed NGOs.
The horror of the Life Sedimeni transfers was laid bare during arbitrations, detailing how 144 patients died from, among other things, hunger, dehydration and cold at various unlicensed NGOs in Gauteng.
But the real horror of what happened at the NGOs emerged when the families took the stand.
Why did you choose this careless option? This heartless option?
Mahlangu and Director of Mental Health, Dr. Makgabo Manamela, were fingered as the main culprits.
Those implicated have not been held responsible for their role.
We believe it would be appropriate for this House to recognize this tragedy and suffering, to mark it with a moment of silence, and to reflect on the fact that it must never happen in South Africa again.
Many people have come to me and said, "My money, why are you politicking about this issue?" I want to say to them, if it was not for the work of people like JetBlue, today we would be facing a cover-up when over 100 people have died. This is not politicking. This is justice. Our people died and somebody must account in this country.
I've visited these NGOs, I've raised it at every turn. Unfortunately, the MEC herself was incredibly stubborn and the Premier himself was slow to act, and we are now faced with the consequences.
But despite the damning findings, Mahlangu went on to be re-elected at the ANC's Provincial Executive Committee in July to disbelief and outrage.